This research provided a scientific basis on which to propose adjustments to Qatar's existing legislation to further protect workers from occupational heat stress. As our recommendations have been assessed for both their health and their productivity outcomes, we hope that they will promote health and well-being and prevent heat illness for all workers in Qatar. We collected and analyzed data covering more than 5,500 working hours. We recorded different parameters of the workers' mental and physical health, their physiology, and their labor effort in a second-by-second basis. This is the largest study of its kind internationally and the first in the Gulf region. Our weather stations recorded high levels of heat in the outdoor workplaces, particularly in the middle part of the day. Nevertheless, workers were able to perform their roles safely when effective heat mitigation measures were in place. One of the key reasons why workers, particularly in the World Cup sites, were able to stay at low levels of occupational heat stress was because of the comprehensive heat stress mitigation plans which were already in place, including cooled and shaded rest areas, mandatory health screenings, specialized cooling workwear, and most importantly, the empowerment of workers to self-pace and take frequent breaks. This was a key element of the heat mitigation plan and allowed them to cope with the high levels of heat and humidity. Another key element of the study was that a number of workers arrive at work at a dehydrated state. This highlights the importance of health education and hydration advice. Finally, we found that workers are more likely to stay cool if they replace their tight and dark colored clothes with light, durable, and clothes made from breathable fabrics. Workers in the World Cup sites were supplied with clothes aiming to keep them cool, and the workers felt that these suits were effective in reducing heat stress. Until recently, the prohibited work period in Qatar was from 11:30 in the morning until 3 o'clock in the afternoon and was in effect between June 15 and August 31st. However, our measurements across multiple workplaces showed that people working under the sun are at high levels for occupational heat stress as early as 10 o'clock in the morning and from the beginning of June until the end of September. This prompted us to recommend an expansion of the prohibited work period to make sure that workers are effectively protected. The wet bulb globe temperature, which is also known by its initials as WBGT, is a widely recognized index for environmental heat stress and its impacts on human health and performance. It is recognized as the most effective index for occupational heat stress assessment and mitigation. The aim for a WBGT threshold is to have an exposure that could extend over hours, where individuals could perform their work routines safely at a low risk for their health. Our research showed that this risk remains low as long as WBGT is below 32.1 degrees Celsius. This threshold is similar to that adopted in several other countries. As in most other countries, about one-third of manual laborers in Qatar suffer from conditions such as diabetes and hypertension that increase their risk for experiencing heat illness when they work in a hot environment. This is why it is really important to conduct annual health checks to prevent, to diagnose, and to manage chronic health conditions and to educate them to remain fit for duty. We know that many companies in Qatar, including those working on World Cup sites, are already conducting comprehensive medical checks, which are a key component of heat stress mitigation. Qatar is well known for its high temperatures, particularly during the summer. However, no research had been done in Qatar or any other country in the Gulf region to assess whether these high heat levels affect some or all of the workers, to what extent, and which heat mitigation measures are more appropriate to adopt. Adopting mitigation measures that have been developed in another country or context can be unproductive, and more importantly, can be dangerous for workers' health and well-being. That's why it was important to perform a wide assessment in real field conditions, testing different mitigation measures and providing context-specific guidance to the government and the responsible enterprises. And we were very happy that we were commissioned to do this work by the International Labour Organization, the Qatar Ministry of Labour, and the Supreme Committee for Delivery and Legacy.